everyone, Amanda Patty here. So today we're going to take a look at cat-cow from yoga and expand upon it so we can connect more fully to our spine as well as do some core work as well and really allow ourselves to move from the center out in a super controlled way. So if we look at the basic cat-cow as it's taught in many yoga classes, from the basic tabletop position, starting with a nice neutral long spine, we inhale up into cow pose and exhale round into cat. Inhale into cow, exhale round into cat. Inhale, cow, exhale, cat. Now, what are some common misalignments and things that I tend to see in this? One is the elbows moving as you're going through the poses. So it's really important to lock out the arms. Now, the elbow pits don't have to be all the way forward because that can put added stress onto the shoulder joints itself. It's okay if the elbow pits are facing each other. So that the shoulder to elbows is 90 degrees, elbow pit to wrist is 90 degrees. Second most common thing I tend to see in yoga classes is a super loosey-goosey midsection. So the ribs continually drop down. We want to keep the ribs up and engaged. So to begin to up-level our cat-cow and take it into one that invites an exploration of feeling each and every single one of our vertebra, as well as engaging and connecting to our core, we're gonna slow the entire process down. So I'm sure most of us have heard of the limbo. Hello, can you go? Well, for this, it's going to be how slow can you go? And it's okay if it takes you a few breaths or several breaths for each pass, for each movement into cat or each movement into cow. It's not so much how quickly can I move and just unite my breath with movement. It's how deeply can I allow myself to connect to my core and the core of who I am in this process and really give myself permission and space to support myself where I am at, as well as give myself room to grow. So we begin in the basic tabletop position. Again, if the ribs drop down and the bum sticks up, engage to the midsection. So already my core is pretty tight. And just take a few breaths here and just connect to your body. Feel what it feels like to really feel rooted strongly into your arms as well as your legs and your core. You should feel fully connected in this pose. You can even imagine that your hands are sliding away from you and your feet, your legs, your knees are sliding in the opposite direction. That provides a little extra tension and invites a little bit more core engagement. Again, be careful here when we don't dip into this. That's core disengagement. You want core engagement. We also don't want over engagement here. Just a nice neutral position in the spine. And then with an exhale, begin by drawing the tailbone down and in towards the ground so that the lower back begins to round vertebra by vertebra. It's not by just scooping the tailbone under and just solely moving your pelvis. This isn't twerking. Or for lack of a better description, how connected can we get to our core? So with your exhale, you begin by drawing the lower belly in, thinking of the navel moving up and through your back. As it does that, the tail drops down. And then, vertebra by vertebra, by drawing the ribs in and back really strongly, we're starting to think, how can I move the back of my spine away from the floor and up towards the ceiling? Vertebra by vertebra by vertebra by vertebra and by vertebra all the way through the neck and the cervical spine. Now as we begin to come back the other way, there are a couple of different ways to do it for this one, and I'll show you
one of several ways that I've learned. We're going to lead with our head. So the head is going to lean, moving into cervical extension slowly. Again, how slow can you go? Nothing else changes until we get to the point where our head has lifted. And then we can begin to melt vertebra by vertebra down through the thoracic spine. Until we eventually get to the tail. And then we repeat the process. Starting with the core, engage the core and think of your stomach being pulled up and back in the opposite direction. That will initiate the flow down through the tailbone. And again, the only thing that changes is where the spine is moving in that moment. Nothing else shifts until we reach that portion of the spine. Then it can begin to shift and change. Again, super, super slow, vertebra by vertebra. This encourages deep connection and movement through every facet of the spine. So that would be repeated 3 times in each pass. So we do 3 times cow and 3 times cat. 3 times the whole thing. Cat, cow, cat, cow, cat, cow, neutral. And notice how different your spine feels. Notice how connected you feel to your core. And also pay particular attention, it's a deep invitation for a lot of the yogis, where your habitual patterns encourage you to clunk through the movement versus allowing each of the single vertebrae to move individually. Give it a try. If you have any questions, comment in the comment section below. Please do like this video and share it with anybody you know who may find this beneficial. Thanks so much and have an awesome day.